implement, which means that he's going to start a warm-up compound movement. For beginners, a compound movement is an exercise that involves multiple muscle groups. The first exercise will be an isolation exercise, which works only one muscle group, and in this case, the lat. By warming up the compound movement, we warm all the muscles up for the isolation movement, and we also have the opportunity to set the weight so we can do truly a superset where there's no rest in between and screwing around with the weight. The weight's going to be set. He goes boom from here to the Buddha. Now let's do our warm-up here. Mark this with a fairly lightweight. Ray, if you can't do it, don't do it.
I can do it.
Go ahead and do it. Warm-up.
See this?
Hold on till we start shooting.
See this nearly right here?
Yeah.
Right
repositioned.
There. That's where you're at.
Guys, Mike, we gotta make sure that the light is there. What do you want to put? What is the best way to put the barbell?
I think we turn it around this way. Maybe we lose this here.
All right. Well, let's move.
Awesome,
let's move this.
Right.
Holy shit! Never mind.
What is heavy?
Yeah, we'll just pivot. Let me pivot this in.
You're
in now?
Oh, all right. Yeah, that's an unnatural thing.
Mike, let's see the double bicep. That famous, And Ray, what's your thing?
Trademark.
What is that? What is it that you did? The one that Dorian does?
Yeah, I did it.
All right.
Which one? That one, yeah. You can do that well.
This one, like this. This one, I did that first.
What, this one?
Yeah.
I want to make a point about keeping it sharp.
The first guy.
What?
Well, first him and then you.
What, t-shirt cut it?
No, and t-shirt doesn't cut it anymore.
What?
T-shirt doesn't cut it anymore.
No.
Yeah. Do we have oil?
Normally I do, but this time I didn't bring.
Maybe in your car?
Lotion?
Yeah.
I didn't even bring lotion this time.
Really?
Why not?
Because I didn't think I needed it. But actually, you should always carry castor oil with you because that'll make you look real wet. Real wet. Castor oil.
That's a good thing.
Okay. What's your name again?
Charity.
Charity?
Charity.
Charity.
Yeah, like.
Next video is with you.
Okay, stand by.
Next
stand
do
by.
What?
Next swimsuit video we're doing with you.
Mark?
Okay. I'm sweating.
All right. All right, Mark, you're sweating. Ready?
Okay, stand by.
I'm ready.
Okay, stand by. Stand by, stand by, stand by. No, no, get back. Stand by, roll.
Who's that?
Rolling, ready? Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, action.
All right, Marcus, this is the last exercise of the workout. I know you're tired, but you're coming into the home stretch. There's no reason to hold back. If there were 10 naked girls here, you'd go to failure.
Yes,
you better believe you're better than a guy. All right, let's go. Make sure the hand spacing is equidistant. That's very important, again, for beginners. I've had many clients over the years who will grab the left hand, for instance, too wide compared to the right hand being inwards. That sets up an imbalance which will lead to injury. Very good. You see he makes each breath almost like a set unto itself. He goes down all the way, resets, takes a deep breath, comes back up. You don't bounce the weight off the floor. Wrap your thumbs. Ray, why don't we show that demonstration about the importance of wrapping the thumb around the bar. This is very important.
I don't understand where this came from. People are grabbing bars with their thumbs on top. Now he's going to wrap his thumb. Now hold something.
See how much more stability and strength is derived by wrapping the thumb around the bar? Beginners, please don't forget that.
Always
and intermediate and advanced bodybuilders too. If you made a habit out of it, please break that habit. And all your exercises, you wrap the thumb around the bar.
And your spacing's
all right. This is the last exercise. It is the best exercise in the world because it stimulates more muscles than any other exercise you might think of. We're going to have him do 3 warm-ups like we had him do on the incline press because the back is a lower back is what's called a very delicate articulation. You can damage it very easily if you don't pay attention to proper form, especially on this exercise. So Marcus, step up to the bar. Your feet should be slightly wider than shoulder width. The bar is flush against the shins for about 40 minutes every 8 days. I'm sorry, less than that. Training once every 6 days now. Alright, feeling warmed up?
Yes.
Let's have you do 1 rep of 315. Please put another 45-pound plate on the bar, gentlemen. Please accurately record the number of reps because even a 1 rep increase can be.
Okay. Yo, Pete Burley?
Hey, Steve.
Hey, Steve.
What's the gentleman?
Hey, bye.
What's the gentleman?
Hey, bye.
Ray.
The other one? Hey, Ray.
Yeah.
Put down just a taste. I can see a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
Show me writing on the pad and trail.
Show you writing? Okay.
Writing on the
pad. Okay.
Tell me when you're starting.
Right. Stand by. 5, 4.
As I said in the tape,
your goal is not merely to stimulate growth in a given muscle, but to turn on the body growth mechanism. Remember, indirect
flex. All right, guys, ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it. It's nothing.
All right, Marcus, there's no... Hang on 1 second.